गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट,
टुडे विल कंटिन्यू आवर चैप्टर 13. आवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज रे डायग्राम्स फॉर कॉन्वेक्स मिरर्स. फॉर द स्टडी ऑफ इमेज फॉर्मेशन बाय कॉन्वेक्स मिरर, वी विल अलाउ टू टाइप्स ऑफ पोजिशन फॉर द ऑब्जेक्ट. फर्स्टली द ऑब्जेक्ट कैन बी प्लेस एट इन्फिनिटी एंड सेकेंड एट अ फाइनाइट डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम द मिरर. See here, when the object is placed at infinity, you will get the image at focus. These are the rays which are parallel to the principal axis. They appear to meet at a point focus, and the reflected rays are diverging and appear to meet at focus. Means you are getting point size image at focus. And second, at finite distance beyond center of curvature, if you place the object, then you will get the image on the other side of the mirror between pole and focus. The image is diminished small size image you are getting, and it is upright between pole and focus when the object is placed at a finite distance. At a measure distance we can measure it. At infinity means we can't measure the distance where the object is placed. It is at infinity and you are getting point size image at focus. And when the object distance is finite, then you are getting image between pole and focus. It is also small size upright image you are getting. And it is real or virtual? Nature of the image, image mirror distance, then size of the image. Point size means it is smaller, then image orientation inverted or large, or in this case it is smaller in size. Nature of the image is real. In concave mirror, the reflected light rays actually meet at a point, while in plane mirror, convex mirror, they only appear to be coming from a common point. The position, size, etc. of a virtual image is found by extending the light rays in ray diagram backward. See here, the rays are appear to meet. They are not actually meet. Here, the rays are shown by dotted line. Dotted line means they appear to meet. You are getting virtual image. Here, you are also getting virtual image, but it is upright. This artificial extension is shown by dotted lines. Real image is always inverted. If you are getting real image, then it is always inverted, and virtual image is always erect. It is upright image. Relation between parameters for spherical mirror. For different position of the object placed in front of a spherical mirror, the position of the image and size of the image also varies. If you change the object distance or object place in front of a spherical mirror, then definitely the position of the image and size of the image also changes. Can we find a relation between the various parameters involved in image formation so that we can calculate the image properties? First of all, let us classify the various parameters, variable and constant of the mirror. In order to find out the image properties, you have to find out the parameters. Which parameters? Variables and constants of the mirror. Variable means whose quantities can change in value for each instance of image formation. Those quantities which can change in value for each instance of image formation. Fix, these are those quantities that hold the same value once mirror and object have been chosen. They can only be changed if the mirror is changed. वेरिएबल दीज आर दोज क्वान्टिटीज. ये वेरिएबल्स कौन सी क्वान्टिटीज है विच कैन चेंज इन वैल्यू. इस वैल्यू में चेंजेस फॉर ईच इंस्टेंस ऑफ इमेज फॉर्मेशन. वी आर गेटिंग डिफरेंट इमेज इफ वी आर चेंजिंग द पोजिशन ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट एंड द वैल्यूज आर ऑल्सो चेंजिंग. दिस क्वान्टिटीज वी कॉल वेरिएबल. बट द फिक्स क्वान्टिटीज आर दोज क्वान्टिटीज दैट इज इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट पोजिशन. वेदर यू चेंज द ऑब्जेक्ट पोजिशन
there is no change in these quantities. And which are these quantities? Value, same value once the mirror and object have been chosen. They can only be changed if mirror is changed. That is the focal length of the mirror, then object size. These are fixed quantities. The values cannot be changed by changing in position of the object. See here, variables are focal length of the mirror, then radius of curvature, object height, then magnification. And fixed are the object mirror distance, distance between object and mirror distance, it is fixed. Then image mirror distance is also fixed and height of the image is also fixed. These are the fixed quantities. Now let us see the relation between focal length and radius of curvature. Focal length is denoted by letter F and radius of curvature by capital R. We shall try to arrive at a relation between F and R using previous learnt mathematical knowledge by drawing ray diagram for a concave mirror. Take a concave mirror with a center of curvature C. Here C is the center of curvature of a concave mirror, P is the pole, F is the focus and CP is the principal axis. Now we can see that ray AB parallel to the axis CP gets reflected along PF. This AB is your incident ray. As soon as it falls on the mirror, concave mirror, it gets reflected in the direction BF. Means BF is your reflected ray and AB is your incident ray. We know that the line CB will normal at B, and this line, dotted line CB, it is normal at B, making an angle of 90 degree at B. Therefore, angle ABC is equal to angle CBF. It is angle of incidence and angle of reflection. The angle between the incident ray and normal is called angle of incidence, and the angle between the normal and the reflected ray is angle of reflection. Laws of reflection, angle I is equal to angle R. Therefore, angle ABC is equal to angle CBF from laws of reflection. But ABC is equal to, this ABC is equal to CBF. CBF. See this ABC, this is your angle of incidence, then CBF is your angle of reflection, I is equal to R, laws of reflection, then angle ABC is also equal to angle BCF. Why? Because if you observe this carefully, this CP and AB are parallel to each other, and CB is their transversal, then they are alternate interior angles. This angle I and this angle, they are alternate interior angles. Hence they are equal. ABC is equal to angle BCF. Then from this equation 1 and this equation 2, we can say that BCF is equal to CBF. BCF is equal to CBF. If these two angles are congruent, then the side opposite to these angles are corresponding sides are also congruent, because these two angles are congruent, means it becomes isosceles triangle. Triangle CBF is your isosceles triangle because these two angles are congruent and side opposite to them are also congruent. Therefore, CF is equal to BF. Right? If the mirror is small and put point P is very close to point B, then we can assume if the mirror is very small, then this F is equal to P, or we can say P is very close to point B. This P is very close to point B. Then we can assume BF is equal to PF or FP. Why BF is equal to FP? If the mirror is very small and the point P is very close to B, in such situation BF is equal to FP or PF. From this equation 3rd and 4th, that is CF is equal to BF, this CF is equal to BF and BF is equal to FP, we can say that BF, CF is equal to PF. This CF is equal to PF or FP. Then CP is equal to CF plus PF or FP. Then PF is PF plus FP. But these two are congruent. Then CP is equal to twice PF, and what is CP? It is R, radius of curvature. R is equal to twice F, this distance is F. Then R is equal to F by 2, or F is equal to R by 2. This is the formula which we obtain. Focal length is equal to half radius of curvature, and this is the important derivation. You draw the diagram and try to solve the derivation. This relation is valid for all spherical mirror, convex and concave. The only condition is that the radius of curvature should be very large, so that point B and pole can assume to be close to enough. One condition is that radius of curvature should be very large, so that point B and P close enough, and we can assume BF is equal to FP. Now next is relation between object distance U, image distance V, and focal length F of the mirror. The distance of the object from pole P is called object distance U. Distance of image from the pole is called image distance V, and the distance between the focal point F and pole is called focal length of the mirror. See here, this distance between F and P, focus and pole, we called it F. Then image distance and object distance, that I am showing you. Here you are getting image, distance of image from pole, that is image distance, and distance of object from pole is object distance. It is denoted by U, and this distance is denoted by V. These three quantities are related to the mirror formula. What is the relation between these three distances? It is 1 by V plus 1 by U is equal to 1 by F. This relation holds true for all spherical mirror. While solving question, take care to insert U, V and F in the mirror formula with proper sign. You have to You can use this formula as mirror formula, but the sign while using this formula, sign convention. See, if it is a concave mirror, then U and F are always negative. For concave mirror, your object distance and focal length is always negative. For real image formation to take place, V will be negative. If the image obtained is real, then V is negative. And V is positive, it means image is virtual. And if you are getting virtual image, then V is positive. This sign convention you have to remember while using this formula, 1 by V plus 1 by U is equal to 1 by F. Now next is magnification. See, all these properties we have already studied in chapter reflection and refraction from plane surfaces. Magnification produced by spherical mirror is the proportional change in size of the image as compared to that of the object. See, image, size of the image upon height of the size of the object, that we called ratio. This is the ratio, we called it magnification. Height of the object H and that of the image is I. Image height upon object height. This ratio is called magnification. It is denoted by letter M. M is equal to I upon H. That formula is M is equal to I by H. It can also be expressed in terms of object U and image distance V. That image distance means it is V and object distance is U. M is equal to minus V by U. It is obvious that is a measure of object proportional to change in size, and we know that for a given mirror and object, the object height is fixed, but the change in position of the object, image height change. See, object height is always constant, it is a fixed quantity, but image height may change. If I is equal to H, then M is equal to I by H and is equal to 1. Magnification become 1 only when the height of the image and height of the object is same. But I is greater than H, means image height is greater than object height, that time value of magnification is greater than 1, and if image height is less than object height, then magnification is less than 1. H is taken as positive because usually the object is placed on the principal axis and standing upward. See, all the values of H you have to take plus or positive. For virtual image, the image height should be taken as positive, and for real image as negative. If you are obtaining real image, then its value become negative, and for virtual image it is positive. This means that magnification will be positive for virtual images and negative for real images. This science you have to remember. Now next part is uses of spherical mirror. Where we use these spherical mirrors? Usually concave mirrors are used in torch, searchlight, headlight of vehicle to obtain a parallel beam of light, and they are also employed as shaving mirror to obtain a large image of a face. Dentists use this type of mirror to obtain magnified image of tooth, and large size concave mirrors are used to focus sunlight in solar power plant. See, concave mirror, it is generally used to obtain enlarged image of object. Whatever the object is, if you want the enlarged image, magnified image of that object, then you have to use concave mirror. Dentist, if dentist is examining your tooth, then what are the faults in the tooth? He need magnified image, hence he use concave mirror. Large size concave mirrors are also used if you want to focus sunlight. That time you have to use concave mirrors. Then shaving mirrors are also obtain large size image of a face. Concave mirror. Then concave mirrors are also used to focus the light, search light, headlight of the vehicle. You have seen headlight of the vehicles, and then torch. Which mirror is used? Concave mirror. Concave mirror gives us large magnified image of any object. Then what? Convex mirror. Where it is used? The mirror that you see on the side of a car, which the driver uses to see the images of the vehicle behind him, are convex mirror. This side images or side of the car or side of any two wheelers, you have seen the two mirrors are there, and these two mirrors are generally used to view the images behind him, and these mirrors use are convex mirrors. What is the use of the mirror? These mirrors are used to see or view the images behind, and they are used as rear view mirror. Convex mirrors are also used as rear view mirror because they always form, image form is not erect. Again, it is not inverted. Upright image you are getting. But the disadvantage is that image is smaller than the object. Though it is diminished, you are getting small size image of the object, but it is not upright. It is not inverted. It is upright image. You are getting upright diminished image. Maximum area of backside is covered. If you are getting small image of the object, since they are curved in a manner bulging outward, and they have a large field of view, you can view maximum behind what is actually, which vehicle is coming from behind, that you can easily view. Hence they use concave mirror. Some supermarket have now installed large concave mirror at the turning so that two customers don't collide. These mirrors are also used in supermarket. Have you seen this in supermarket, these mirrors? So that two customers coming from different side do not collide on each other. One numerical is given. You try to solve this numerical in your copy. Now, we conclude by saying that a mirror of a focal length 15 cm, the image of an object placed 10 cm away, distance plus 6 cm, size of the image 0.6 times, and since the magnification produced is positive, we can say the image is virtual and erect. With all these properties we have already discussed, you go through it. And our next topic is refraction at spherical surfaces. Before that, you try to solve the derivation, that is the relation between R and F, radius of curvature and focal length. Thank you.